的中华电视会带大家去到 ABC Studios 看看由悠悠苏带来绝妙的萨斯克瓦表演。另外，我们会探究一下多元文化在澳大利亚的重要性，还有不寻常的沙画艺术。不过，首先带来的是一场在墨尔本举行的精彩比赛。现在，我们来看一下在墨尔本龙舫皇宫举行的2011年国际金茶王奶茶制作比赛墨尔本分区赛。
We'll go into countdown 3, 2, 1 and get ready, OK? 我哋大家你哋会有20分钟的准备时间。You all will have 20 minutes to prepare your milk tea for our judges.Okay, 3, 2, 1, let's go!
这次的比赛一共有12名选手，比赛规则是每位选手在20分钟内准备4杯奶茶给4位评委。港式奶茶第一次出现是在英国统治下的香港殖民时期。英式的下午茶就是喝红茶时与牛奶和糖配合，在香港变得非常受欢迎。奶茶的原理与英式下午茶相似，不过原来是配以牛奶的，现在多数用脱脂牛奶或炼乳代替。制作奶茶时，首先要把茶叶和水煮沸，再用温火慢煮3到6分钟。一些参赛者甚至觉得心情的好坏对奶茶的质量有直接的影响。因为制作奶茶常常要用一个像裤袜的大型茶袋冲泡奶茶，因此港式奶茶也有裤袜奶茶或丝袜奶茶之称。但是今天的参赛者们会用麻布袋来冲泡他们的代表作。麻布袋的另一个作用就是用来过滤茶叶。当茶煮了大概3分钟左右，很多人都把茶壶从加热处移开冷却，然后再把茶壶放回重新煮沸。一些选手一直重复这项程序，他们认为这样可以让茶味更浓郁。很多选手认为时间的掌握很关键，他们相信这是泡出好奶茶的秘密之道。但是全场最关心的还是究竟谁能夺得2011年国际金茶王的荣誉。评判一杯好的奶茶的标准包括奶茶的颜色、香味、 温度、味道和奶与茶分量的平衡度。评判的工作很艰难，他们需要非常专注和有大量的经验去判断哪杯奶茶才是最好的。一杯好奶茶的首要条件就是要香滑，奶茶的质地要像奶油般柔滑和饱满。除此之外，评委们看重的是奶茶的香味和口感是否丰富，要达到这个标准，水温是重点。另一个判断奶茶好坏的标准是当喝完奶茶后，杯沿上是否留有白色的泡沫残留。这些白色的泡沫证明了所有的脱脂牛奶里面乳脂的含量是否够高。选手们的技巧需要非常的高超，因为他们的对手就站在旁边，而且每个人都在为拿到奶茶冠军而努力。
在我的排行榜升来升去，不管一二三四。
所有的参赛者都给予了一张证书，但现场的气氛变得非常紧张，所有的参赛者都等待着最终获奖结果的宣布。
International Gamcha Competition 2011 Australia Melbourne Region 国际金茶王大赛2011港式奶茶澳洲墨尔本区决赛的冠军就是，哇，他的名字厉害了，一听到他的名字就威震全球啊，是几号啊？
十号。
梁振威，够大威啊！多谢晒 Eric 你，多谢晒你哋今日事务所帮我哋核数下，多谢晒你。
今年的比赛圆满落幕，期待下一年的比赛更加精彩。究竟这次的冠军能否在2012总决赛卫冕，还是一山更比一山高呢？请继续关注中华电视给您带来的最新资讯。休息过后，我们会研究一下多元文化在澳大利亚的重要性。欢迎回到中华电视。工党议员 Maria Van Vickno 连同自由党议员 Russell Broadbent 在一起推广多元文化在澳大利亚的好处。
We wanted a bipartisan approach where both parties, and including the Greens, were involved in addressing multiculturalism as a mainstream issue and celebrating the diversity of who we are as a nation.And how important multiculturalism has been for Australia and will be into the future.
That's right. And it's very important at this time to be reaffirming Australia's multicultural identity and to bring the term multiculturalism back into the political agenda, to show, well, actually to reconnect with the positive aspects of multiculturalism. And in particular, as I said earlier, with the younger generation of Australians who are young people growing up in a global community.And who live in a country that, by nature, by virtue of its immigrant past, is the globe living in this country. So I think we've got so much going for us. It's important to remember that and reaffirm it. People that live in this country are united. We're equal. We are equal under our citizenship. We're Australians who are very diverse. We come from culturally diverse backgrounds, from different faiths, and from we speak different languages. And this country has been built from the ground up that way. Europe faces a different problem. Europe.Monocultural societies that are having difficulty absorbing diversity, and we always say it's different because, for example, unlike Germany, where migrants were never allowed to take up German citizenship, they were always guest workers and migrants, they were different. Australia has always embraced its people on an equal level, and that's what's important about us.
My name is Stefanos. I'm a sand artist or sand animation artist. The technique is simply drawing images and moving, shifting the sands on glass through light. It's called an evolving art because it constantly evolves. One image changes into another one and it clears. The surprise of it is sometimes you're not sure what's going to come up next. And yeah, it's very unique.
继续收看中华电视，休息过后我们将会带来悠悠苏令人绝妙的萨克斯管表演。欢迎回到中华电视，现在我们就和墨尔本 ABC 演播室的现场观众一起来享受这场由悠悠苏和 David Mikinu 带来的音乐盛宴吧。